Hello everybody, thank you so much for watching. My name is Alexander, I'm a Porsche certified brand ambassador at Porsche West Palm Beach, and thank you so much for watching my YouTube videos. If you like my YouTube walkaround videos, please consider subscribing to my channel, please hit the like button and feel free to comment down below. You can also contact me directly via cell phone or email, with my contact information being in the video description. In today's YouTube walkaround video, we're going to take a look at this very special and spectacular 2022 Porsche 911 GT3 Touring. This vehicle just arrived at our dealership. Congratulations to the owner on specking such a fantastic GT3 Touring. And also thank you so much to the owner for allowing me to do a YouTube walkaround video on your brand new Porsche. So of course, we're gonna start with the exterior details on this specific car. And we're gonna start with the paint color, which is a very special one. This specific car is painted in paint to sample Irish green. Now, to a lot of Porsche enthusiasts, Irish green will have a lot of meaning, but kind of elaborating on that specific choice, the first ever Porsche 911 to be produced, given to Ferry Porsche by his father, was painted in Irish green. So a very classic, meaningful color within the Porsche brand. Therefore, Irish green also became a Porsche favorite within the Porsche family. And here we have the modern day GT3 Touring painted in that same color. Spectacular, of course, with that classic look against the black accents. So let's do a tour next to the paint to sample color. We're going to take a look at the front. Where of course we see the redesigned front fascia for the latest generation 911 GT3 Touring. The Touring was initially introduced on the previous generation car, the 991 GT3 Touring, which Porsche produced for 2018 and 2019. And now we have the latest generation here, the second generation, in the 2022. Looking at the front, we see the redesigned front fascia, very large intake system of course here to feed all the air to the front. Of course, this will create downforce. And of course, that air also will be directed to the front place radiator, which is very large in dimensions. Porsche also relocated the positioning of this radiator to a deeper position within the front of the car. Therefore, also the nostril system, which used to be on the front bumper of the previous generation GT3 Touring, is now relocated to the front hood. Again, also significantly larger in sizing. And also the hood itself is actually now made out of carbon fiber, while on the previous generation Touring, the hood was still made out of aluminum. Also here in the middle, we can see the design change here on the aerodynamics of the front hood. The previous generation did not have that design aerodynamically. This was introduced on the RS models a few years ago. And you can see Porsche also using it on the latest generation GT3 Touring. Going here to the side, we can see the new design center locking wheels, which are standard for every Porsche 911 GT3. We have 20 inches in the front, we have 21 inches in the back. Again, another technical difference between the previous generation and the new one. The previous generation running both 20 inch in the front as 20 inch in the back, and now we have 21 inches in the back. We also have a wider tire. Previous generation running a 305 rear section tire, the new generation running a 315. Next to the center locking wheels, which of course are very lightweight, you can also see that the owner chose to have the wheels painted by Porsche in satin black, creating this beautiful sporty contrast against the Irish green color. And you can also see right behind the black painted center locking wheels, the optional PCCB, the Porsche carbon composite brake system. Of course, the highest performance level of brakes within the Porsche brand. Again, redesigned versus the previous generation with an even larger diameter front rotor made out of carbon ceramic. And of course, the brand new caliper painted by Porsche in yellow to indicate the technology of the carbon ceramics. Getting here more to the side, we have the first Porsche exclusive manufacture option on this car, where you can see that the lower section of the mirror trim has also been painted in Irish green. Normally the mirror cap is only painted in, of course, exterior color, and the lower section is not. But in this case, you see the whole mirror assembly has been painted in the beautiful Irish green color. Going here to the bottom section of the new GT3 Touring, we can see a significantly larger side skirt as the previous generation car. Again, from aerodynamic standpoint, the new vehicle has significantly more downforce, even in the Touring specification. You want to create it as wide underbody as possible. It has a lot of air vanes also placed underneath the vehicle. And by creating just a little bit bigger side skirt, you have a larger underbody and therefore better aerodynamics on the bottom section of the vehicle. Continuing to the back, we have another change in terms of the windows. So the previous generation GT3 was running still traditional glass rear windows. But now the new GT3, both in the wing car as in the Touring, these are now made out of polycarbonate, of course introduced a few years ago on the RS models. But now even the GT3 running a side window here made out of polycarbonate, and also a back window made out of polycarbonate. Before we get to the back of the vehicle, we also see the first carbon fiber element here applied on this specific car by the carbon fiber roof by Porsche. Beautiful gloss, I love that dual tone effect against the Irish green. Of course, very lightweight material. And again, that's a technology we saw on the RS a few years ago, but again, now made its way over to the GT3 model. Okay, time to take a look at the back. Again, I mentioned, of course, a 315 rear section tire being applied now by Porsche. This is the latest generation tire from Porsche with the new NA1 rating, so specifically developed for the new 992 GT3. Very sticky tire, of course, performance tire. Love that setup. Rear axle steering system still standard, of course, introduced initially in 2014 on the first gen GT3 of the 991 and also the Turbo S model, and standard ever since. So the GT3 running a beautiful rear axle steering system, of course, redesigned for 992, especially with the new wider tire and of course the 21 inches on the back. Okay, GT3 Touring, the wingless GT3, this classic design, the GT3 performance, of course, in terms of suspension and engine, running the same springs as the car with the wing, running the same engine, of course, as the car with the wing, but now a little bit more calm in terms of not having this large fixed rear wing on the back. It does, of course, does have a rear spoiler, 25% larger as the previous generation car, which is, of course, significant. Also with the wing now also going all the way into the fenders when it's up in the up position, looks fantastic, in my opinion, on the latest generation car. Also, the engine deck is specific. So, of course, we have the GT3 Touring name here on the back. It is completely different versus the wing car, especially, of course, because the intake system to this engine had to be redesigned because of not having this large fixed rear wing. But again, specific to the Touring, looking fantastic. We also saw that on the previous generation car. Getting here to the lower section, of course, we see the new rear fascia. Again, the word downforce coming in here as a very important factor, as we see a significantly larger and wider rear diffuser on the bottom section of the vehicle. If you look at the previous generation car, it was basically running a diffuser system similar to that 911R, which was much more narrow in terms of its dimensions. Now the diffuser coming all the way here to the back, almost the entire width here of the rear bumper. And again, of course, downforce, downforce, downforce. In the middle, still the Porsche Sport exhaust system. Of course, fantastic in terms of engine sound with the active flaps within the exhaust system. Now this one is the GT3 Touring package in black. That's why the exhaust tips are finished in black. We also have the original GT3 Touring package, which will be a silver finish on the exhaust tips. Engine 4-liter flat six. Initially introduced a few years ago on the 911 Speedster. This engine has been around now for a few years, but again updated by Porsche to run it in the new 992. The big word there is individual throttle bodies. So yes, the previous GT3 was also 4-liter flat six, had the same red line as 9000 RPM, but did not run the individual throttle bodies, which again were introduced on the Speedster. Also in terms of sound, I feel when I hear the new 992 GT3 Touring that it just has a little bit more bass tone to it. And I can only imagine at 9000 RPM with a manual transmission, how astonishing that will be on this car. You can also see that the Porsche letters, of course, are blacked out, which is a GT3 standard. And then we don't see any GT3 badging here on the back of the vehicle. Of course, it is applied here on the top section. Okay, so we covered most of the details on the outside. What a spectacular exterior detail that this car has, but it continues definitely on the inside. Please follow me. Where the inside has more special features, again from the Porsche exclusive manufacture department. We're going to start with the additional carbon fiber that was applied in this car. So we know, of course, the roof has been made out of carbon fiber, but also more carbon fiber trim here in the door panel. So we have a strip of carbon in gloss on this specific vehicle starting here in the door. That gloss carbon fiber continues into the side sill in the bottom section. So the beautiful GT3 model designation there in the side sill in gloss carbon fiber. And then more carbon fiber applied in the dashboard, starting to the left of the steering wheel, going all the way across to the right-hand side, again in the gloss version of the carbon fiber. There is even more carbon fiber, and you guys might already spotted it, of course, the lightweight bucket carbon fiber seats. So a seat shell completely made out of carbon fiber. You can see here the backside of it. Then we have the beautiful black leather applied, and then we have the specific cloth material here in the middle that is specific to the Touring model. So this specific material is on the lightweight bucket seat, specific to the Touring. Now you might have already spotted also this in beautiful detail. We have the deviated stitching package applied by Porsche exclusive manufacturer in this car. Now deviated stitching packages are many choices to choose from in terms of stitching color. This specific car has the speed yellow deviated stitching. You'll see most cars being fitted with racing yellow stitching. This car has the speed yellow stitching applied on the carbon fiber bucket seat, applied on the door panel here on the top side and the middle side, all the way into the armrest also of the door panel. Also the top section of the dashboard going all the way across. Once again, the speed yellow stitching and also the beautiful detail of the steering wheel, once again finished with speed yellow stitching together with the center armrest. Of course, also we have some comfort features in terms of front axle lift system, with the press of a button to be able to raise the front axle by 1.5 inches, about 4 centimeters, for the extra ground clearance. PCM navigation system standard on the GT3, the same with the keyless start on the latest generation. So we do see some more modern technology from the, let's say, the 992 Carrera models or the Turbo Turbo S making its way to the GT3. So in terms of daily drivability, in terms of electronic luxury, you'll see a big step on this car versus the 991 GT3 Touring models. So beautiful black leather, the deviated stitching on the inside. You might have already spotted also the instrument dial in the middle in front of the driver has been finished in white. And then we see also the beautiful sport chrono clock on top of the dashboard, also finished in white in this specific car. Touring models, or GT3 models in general, being such a track-focused, lightweight, race car spec 911, do not have rear seats. It is beautifully finished also in the back, but no ability, of course, to have any humans there in the back. So that's very important to know. Again, all lightweight, the pure sense of driving, the manual transmission, and of course, to touch on that, it is a 6-speed manual transmission, not a 7-speed like you see on the Carrera models, or Carrera S, or a GTS, I should say. This transmission, once again, is a carryover from the previous generation car. It's a short shifter in terms of the length of the shifter itself, specifically tailored to this 4-liter flat six. Just a perfect combination of this screaming 9,000 RPM car with the 6-speed short shifter. Top speed, around 200 miles an hour, so just incredible performance level, but of course, all about the purity of driving. Thanks so much for watching this YouTube video. My name is Alexander, Porsche certified brand ambassador at Porsche West Palm Beach. If you like my YouTube videos, again, please consider subscribing. Hit that like button, as it truly helps with the YouTube algorithm and therefore the growth of the channel. This is one of these most special GT3 Tourings I was ever able to present on my YouTube channel. So once again, thank you so much to the owner, and I'll see you guys next time. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.